Hello everybody, welcome back to Luxx Biz. I'm Tatiana and today I have the pleasure of interviewing Jeremiah Kovacs. Jeremiah is the founder of MuseMinded, which will automate your Amazon financials. So if you don't like accounting and you don't want to have to deal with it yourself, he's the guy to go to. So Jeremiah, thank you so much for being here. I appreciate
pleasure
your time.
Yeah,
why don't we just start off by kind of telling people what is MuseMinded?
Sure. So we are an accounting firm that specializes in just one client. 100% of our client base are Amazon sellers. So that's folks that just starting off all the way to several million dollars a year. Mm-hmm. And kind of our core idea is like, we want you to get this whole financial corner of your business on lockdown. And the two ways we do that is we have DIY courses where you can learn how to do it yourself, which no one particularly loves to do, and that's why we offer those courses for free.
Okay.
So we'll teach you step by step the exact process and the exact tools that we use to automate that part of their business. And if, honestly, for a lot of folks, especially if they're on the lower end, it takes like 30 minutes, yeah, 30 minutes, an hour, a month to do their own bookkeeping once the system is up and running and going.
That's super generous because a lot of people can't always afford something in the beginning,
sure,
so they can start there.
Yeah, and it's the exact same process we use for our clients. So like something that people are paying thousands and thousands of dollars for every year, you can learn how to do that for free. And the idea is that once you start to do it yourself and eventually you're gonna grow up and you wanna, you know, your business is gonna get bigger, and then you're gonna leverage your time, leverage your expertise to do things that you are amazing at, and that will help take your business to the next level. And generally, bookkeeping and tax is not that thing.
Yeah.
So we offer a service where we do all of that for you. Very, very affordable. So the pricing is on our website, and when you guys get to that level and you're ready to do that, like literally we'll do it. You're not gonna find someone with more expertise with a better price point.
That's
kind of our,
because you guys focus on the Amazon sellers, so you just have such extensive knowledge about how Amazon works and all that stuff.
So some people charge hourly, right? And it will take them a lot of hours to figure it all out, because you're literally gonna be holding their hand, teaching them what reports to pull and where to go. And we already, we've already seen all that.
Well, actually that's true, because when I was trying to find an accountant for my business, it was hard because not a lot of accountants have experience with online sellers, and particularly Amazon sellers. So that's definitely very niche. And I totally agree with you, leveraging your time. I talk about that a lot on Luxx Biz, how we need to value our time more. And once you kind of get to that higher level, there are things that may require more of your time and attention that are going to add more value to your business. And it's good to outsource the things that can be outsourced. So that's awesome.
Yeah, for sure.
I just wanted to dive into sales tax, because a lot of people, like when they even think about the word sales tax, they feel confused. And so there's a lot of uncertainty around that. So maybe we can talk about what is sales tax and when should someone start thinking about collecting sales tax?
Sure. So sales tax, the big idea is that the government says, hey, you're doing business in our state, and so we want you to collect sales tax from our customers and send it back to us. And that's not a big deal for most traditional businesses. Like, you live in a certain state here in the US, and so you collect, you know, tax from your customers. Where it gets real tough is with this space, the e-commerce space, where you're in one place, but you're selling to customers all over the country. And how do we handle that? And the reason there's so much anxiety and confusion is because on the one end, like, the compliance that you have to do is super high.
Right.
So the idea is like, first of all, if you have employees or your home base is here, you have owners or you have real estate in a state, like every traditional business, you need to get a business license and register for sales tax there.
Mm-hmm.
Where it gets a little tricky is kind of this in between. Some people call it soft nexus, where you have like this semi-permanent presence in a state. So for Amazon sellers, it's if you use the FBA program, you have inventory that is stored and gets staged in a state for a period of time before it moves on to another customer inside or outside that state. And what the way the state see it is, and most tax accountants see it, is that creates a requirement to comply with sales tax laws.
Right.
So that's on the one end that creates all the anxiety and the headache. On the other end, the confusion comes from most sellers usually stick to their home state, and they, all the sellers that they know stick to their home state, and they don't know anybody that's ever got caught.
Right.
So it sort of feels like there's this like, where's the disconnect here? Mm-hmm. And so a lot of sellers don't comply outside their home state because they don't know anyone who ever who has. Mm-hmm. And the cost to go what they see as above and beyond is so high. And in particular in the beginning of your business, your ability to pay is so low. So it, like, it creates this sort of vacuum and this tension, mm-hmm. anxiety, and kind of like, I think some tips for you guys or ways to think about it is, you really need to have a plan. So on the one end, a lot of people, they just out of fear, usually they go and they just comply in all the places that they should comply. And then some people on the other hand, they just bury their head in the sand, right?
Right.
And so what I see a lot of the sellers doing, particularly as they get bigger, is like they find a middle ground. And kind of the idea is you want to set some type of limit for yourself. So what you do is register in your home state, mm-hmm. and then use a tool like taxjar.com, mm-hmm. to monitor your exposure outside of your home state. And then you need to set some limit for yourself. And if you're risk averse, you don't like risk, then set the limit kind of low. And if you're like, you know what, I don't think they're ever going to find me, then maybe set the limit a little higher, right? And what you do is you set this limit for yourself and use TaxJar and tell you once the sales tax that you should have collected, mm-hmm. reaches this threshold, that'll be your signal to go register in the home state.
Right.
And the reason that a lot of sellers are going that direction is because you're not going to do all the states all at once. You're going to get the big risk out of the way probably pretty early on, but mm-hmm. then all the other states, it costs just as much to comply in the small states as the big states. And so a lot of the smaller states, you wait till you have a significant presence there before you start paying significant money,
okay.
to comply with them. And so like one of the things I was that I've noticed with my clients is California, Texas, and Florida, for a lot of people, make up 2/3 of all of their risk and all of their exposure. So some people, they just go sign up in their home state plus those, and they, you know, they're only dealing with a handful of states, mm-hmm. but they're getting almost all their a large portion of their risk off of their back.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So. Yeah. So what I'm hearing is that, you know, you don't have to, sign up in your home state, so where you're based, where you're, you know, selling, where your home is, you're going to have to pay taxes there.
Sure.
But then you don't necessarily have to sign up in all the states at once. So don't feel overwhelmed by this idea that you have to sign up for sales tax permits in all these different states. Okay. First, you know, figure out where you're selling to the most. Figure out maybe where the Amazon warehouse is located, although I know Amazon, sometimes you send them inventory to one warehouse and then they disperse it among all the different warehouses. So you don't really know where your inventory is. But figure out where you're selling to most based on tax jars, see where it is, and then start collecting sales tax in the top states that you're selling in. So that could be like Texas and Florida, maybe New York, California.
Yeah.
I know it is for me. So
yeah,
that makes a lot of sense. So then at that point, how do you know, like, so you were talking about thresholds. So mm-hmm. would you say maybe like when you start collecting $5,000, what you're supposed to collect, how do you know what that threshold is?
Yeah, this is the really difficult question to answer. It really comes down to risk management. So I think of it a lot like insurance, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, with insurance, you don't ever want whatever you're insuring for to happen, like long-term disability or life insurance. Like, but at a certain point, like your risk becomes so big,
mm-hmm.
that it actually makes more sense to pay a small amount of money so that risk is totally off your plate.
Mm-hmm.
So the threshold in how people analyze risk is completely different.
Right.
So like what I might see is 5,000, my threshold might be 5,000 because that seems like a lot of risk for me. If a state was trying to come mm-hmm. after me for more than $5,000, I would flip out, right?
Right.
But for some people, that's 500.
Right.
And you just, so I'm hesitant to give you a universal threshold, but you just need to think like, what if they tried to come after you for a certain amount, like, would that put you under?
Yeah.
Because the risk, the risk of getting found is admittedly quite small. Right. But as you grow longer and longer and longer in business, like that liability accumulates and accumulates. And at some mm-hmm. point, you know, it makes more sense to spend a couple hundred bucks a month to just get all of that risk off of your plate. So that's kind of how I want to help you make a decision that works for you rather than just give mm-hmm. you an arbitrary limit.
And what about for people who are selling internationally, like on different marketplaces? How does that work?
Yeah. So technically the requirement is still intact for international sellers. Okay. As in the same way as US-based sellers. So, because it's all based on your presence, right? So an international seller has this, if they're using FBA and are in the 25 plus states, you have just as much presence as a US-based seller does with your inventory. But here's kind of the issue is like the states have a really hard time policing it. Mm-hmm. So what I see, and not necessarily what I recommend, but what I see a lot of international sellers doing is they are pretty hands-off mm-hmm. until some type of more significant legislation comes in that will allow the states to police the laws better or more thoroughly. Most international sellers are actually pretty hands-off.
Gotcha. So yeah. Now, one thing I do want to mention is that it is illegal to collect sales tax if you do not have a sales tax permit.
Yeah.
So that's very important. Like, you can't just start selling on Amazon and check all the boxes and say, I'm going to collect sales tax for everyone. You have to have a sales tax permit. And so how do you obtain a sales tax permit?
Sure. So let's say once you've hit a threshold, yeah. you're ready to register. The very first step is to register in the state for license. So you have to go, there's no like, I wish there was some like centralized portal yeah. that we could all go to and say, hey, I want to register in California, Texas, and Florida, and New York. It doesn't work that way. You have to go individually to the state's website. It's usually the Department of Revenue is yeah. Where you go, and they'll have a unique workflow. To you have to register on most states, it's online. You have to fill out forms. They're going to ask you when you started selling, mm-hmm. And that's a really important one. So, like, let's say you hit this threshold, they're going to ask you, well, when did you start selling, Tatiana? It's like, if I tell them the beginning of my business, they're going
to
want to ask for the 5,000, what should I do?
What happened in California?
Technically, you're supposed to tell them the beginning of when your inventory first arrived, and you're supposed to pay the back sales tax. What mm-hmm. I see a lot of people doing is they say, you know what, I'm going to comply moving forward, and I'm going to take the risk that they could come ask someday for that, but I'm going to take the calculated risk that I'm going to start complying today, draw a line in the sand, and I'm going to start, you know, mm-hmm. this coming month collecting and remitting.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you just have to go directly to
yeah.
each state and
yeah.
fill out the forms and tell them when you
yeah.
started business.
So that's the annoying part. I've had to do that where you go to every state's website and then you apply. Sometimes you have to mail in the documents, and
yeah.
I live in Canada, so I got to put in the mail. It takes time to get there to register. And then every month you have to submit your sales tax. So every month you have to go in manually and you have to pay that sales tax, make sure you have the right amount. So there is a lot to do. And that's why if you can leverage Jeremiah's services, go for it, because it takes time. It's tedious. Nobody really likes to do it, but you got to get it done.
The way I say it is like registration process is a bear.
Yeah.
You can do it, but it's like most people will charge you $60 to $75 per state to do that.
Mm.
And if you're like talking about the plan that I see a lot of sellers do, it's like you only have to do one or two or three in the first 6 or 12 months of your business. So
mm-hmm.
it's not too bad to get someone to register for you. We can help you out with that, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Check our website for pricing and all of that. And then once you register and you need to do the ongoing filing, an amazing tool is called taxjar.com.
Yeah.
And you basically plug in your information. The state will tell you, hey, Tatiana, you need to, state of California, you need to file quarterly with us. So
yeah.
you log into Taxjar, you tell Taxjar, hey, I'm on a quarterly cadence. And then from there, Taxjar will handle all of that.
Mm-hmm.
If you end up working with us with our compliance package where we do the bookkeeping and income tax, we'll actually help you consult. I'll
mm-hmm.
help get tax jar in place and get your tax settings all squared away in Seller Central and sort of consult with you. But I'm not going to charge you to actually do the filing when I'm just going to set up tax jar for you and then charge you like a margin on top of that.
Yeah.
I think it's easier to just go direct.
So. Yeah, I mean, I actually recently started using tax jar, which is kind of crazy because I've been in this business for 3 years and I hadn't used it before and I realized how simple it was. Yeah. So I'll link that down below for you guys. And you mentioned you guys don't just do like sales tax, you do income tax, what else do you guys do? What other services do you have?
Sure. So the base of all this is bookkeeping. So we'll pull in all your revenue, all your expenses, and help you, we'll track all that for you. That's what the courses teach you how to do as well.
Right.
We do corporate tax filings for US-based businesses. So if you have some type of corporation or if you're an S-Corp is a really popular form, then we'll do all the filing for you. A lot of people are sole proprietors or single member LLCs. And then what we'll do is we'll hand you the business. That's technically for tax. That stuff flows through your personal return. So we'll give you all the business specific tax information you need to plug in to the personal side or give to your personal tax accountant. So yeah, it's bookkeeping, it's business income tax, and it's sales tax consulting.
And you mentioned the different types of entities. I just kind of wanted to touch on that while we're here. In Canada, you know, as a corporation, there are certain benefits, tax benefits. You have lower taxes. So is there a type of entity that is better to set up as a US citizen for an Amazon business?
Sure. So the route I see most people take is they start by creating an LLC, a limited liability company. In most states, it's really inexpensive, like $50 to $100. California's, for all you Californians that are getting shafted with taxes and fees, it's not as attractive for you guys, I'll admit. But it's generally pretty cheap to set up an LLC. And the big business benefit there is the limited liability. So if your business gets sued, they won't necessarily come for your house. So anyways, an LLC is a great place to start. And once your business starts to grow to, you know, 50, I mean, once you start making like $250,000 a year or higher, you might want to consider something called an S corporation. And that's a special tax classification. You can, you file a 2-page form with the IRS and say, hey, I want you to see my LLC as an S corporation. So it like for tax purposes incorporates your business and you can end up saving a lot of taxes there. But most people just go to a single LLC and that works for them for a really long time.
Awesome. Great. Lots of great information here. Thank you so much. And Muse Minded will be linked down below. And Jeremiah, do you have a discount for us?
Yeah, you bet.
Awesome.
So I'm going to hook you guys up 10% off for the first 6 months. You fill out a form on our website to get started, or you can email me and it's going to ask you for a referral code and you can use Luxx 418, LUXX 418, and that'll hook you up 10% off for the first 6 months.
Thank you so much. Yeah, that's great. So again, everything will be linked down below. Jeremiah, thank you so much for your time and
great
for adding
here.
So much value to our audience.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. And if you want to get started with your Amazon FBA business today, then I'm going to send you some free video training. Just so you get a better understanding of how this whole process works, more of a step-by-step in-depth guide, so that you can also enjoy this abundant internet lifestyle. So to gain access, all you got to do is go to luxxhealth.com/onlinebiz, enter your name and your email address and subscribe, and immediately I'm going to send you your first training. But if you don't get that email right away, sometimes it goes to the spam folder. Sometimes you have to opt into the mailing list, so just be aware of that. And don't worry, I'm not going to spam you, but I will be sending you several emails over the course of several weeks, just because I don't want to bombard you with information, too much information at once. You're going to get into analysis paralysis. So look out for my emails, valuable content for you to get started on Amazon, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye guys.